Hey guys, Nayash here. So this is Nusantara OS 1.1, a dedicated gaming Android ROM specially designed for gamers. This custom ROM is available for plenty of Android phones. And in this video, we are going to have a look at its performance, its battery life, its features, and why this is considered best gaming ROM right now. So let's get started. So this is Nusantara OS 1.1. Now they have improved a lot since 1.0 because their previous version 1.0 was really bad. And this new version 1.1 is so good that you can directly compare this with Chorus OS, which is one of the best gaming ROM right now. Fun fact, the main developer of Chorus OS left the group and then he created this Nusantara OS, which is actually better than Chorus OS in gaming. I will talk more about gaming later in this video. Even though this ROM is based on Android 10, you get plenty of features from Android 11. And soon, this will be updated to Android 11 itself. Also, this ROM comes with its own launcher. It might look like Pixel Launcher, but it has plenty of other features. For example, this double tap on screen support. If I double tap on screen, I directly enable volume slider. And the amazing thing is you get complete freedom to customize the way you want. Instead of volume slider, you can enable your flashlight, you can screen off, you can have Google search. And all these amazing features are available in this stock launcher. And if you're a private guy, you can definitely hide or lock any app you want. So now let's go to settings and about and let me show you. This is Nusantara OS 1.1, its official build. It comes with latest security of 5th September and also dedicated gaming custom kernel. Now that's your wish if you want to keep this kernel or want to upgrade to 68fps kernel. In case you want to upgrade to 68fps on this Nusantara OS, I will drop that video in I button. By the way, 68fps kernel and this ROM is deadly combination. When both comes together, you get amazing performance and very good battery life. Not only you get 68fps while gaming, but your day-to-day tasks like scrolling Instagram, scrolling Facebook will be smoother. It's like you just bought new screen for your phone. Now let's talk about the features. You go to settings, there you find this Nusantara Wings. In that you get plenty of themes. Now these are not the normal themes that you get in other rooms, but this is very deep system level themes. Plenty of options for your QS panel. Just have a look. Of course, you can add different extra colors and background colors in this QS panel and make it completely new theme. You can also have different kind of buttons. So basically, this is most advanced themes I have seen in custom ROM in very long time. In QS panel, apart from gaming mode and FPS info, you get this data switch toggle. With this toggle, you can instantly change your active sim for data usage. Then in notification settings, you get this edge lighting feature. You can also customize LED notifications for particular app. With this feature, it's really easy to know if the notification is worth picking up your phone. Then in the miscellaneous settings, you have these rounded corners, screenshot type, and of course this dedicated gaming mode. When gaming mode is on, you won't get disturbed with notification while gaming. Also, my favorite feature is launch music app when you plug in your headphone. So whenever you plug in your earphone, your default music app will launch. Then there is double tap to sleep on status bar. You double tap on your status bar from any screen, your phone goes to sleep. Then you have other common features like status bar, lock screen. Now these are the features that you find in almost all the custom ROMs. So I won't talk about these common features. So now let's talk about the gaming. While playing PUBG or Call of Duty, you will get amazing gaming performance in this ROM. Touch response while gaming in this ROM is amazing, it's better than MIUI and plenty of other stock ROMs out there. Also, you get lock 60fps on your gameplay. So the gameplay is quite smooth and snappy. So with this stock kernel, if you're using the screen recorder while gaming, your FPS will drop to 50fps. But as I said, if you install that 68fps kernel while screen recording, you will still get 63 or 64fps in your game. So even if you play for longer hours, your phone will not overheat. I have experienced that while I was in MIUI because I was stuck in bootloader. So in MIUI, if you play for 1 hour, your phone gets very hot and then your phone randomly reboots. But that's not the problem with this ROM. So download links are in description alongside how to install this ROM. And also let me know in the comments if you want to see 70fps kernel video.